Let's read SBF's apology letter and see what we can learn from this. Hi all, I feel deeply sorry about what happened. I regret what happened to all of you, and I regret what happened to customers. You gave everything you could for FTX and stood by the company and me. I didn't mean for any of this to happen, and I would give anything to be able to go back and do things over again. You are my family, I've lost that, and our old home is an empty warehouse of monitors. When I turn around, there's no one left to talk to. I'm disappointed all of you, and when things broke down and failed to communicate, I froze up in the face of pressure and leaks that Binance, LOL, and said nothing. I lost track of the most important things in the commotion of company growth. I care deeply about you all, and you are my family, and I'm sorry. I was CEO, and it was my duty to make sure that ultimately the right things happened to FTX. I wish I had been more careful. Dude, you lost $12 billion. It's not about being careful. I want to give you a better description of what happened when I should have written out as best that I understood it much earlier. I deeply regret oversight failure. In retrospect, I wish that we had done many things differently, to name a few. A, being substantially more skeptical about the large margin positions. That's why we never trade on margin. B, examining stress test scenarios involving hyper-correlated crashes and simultaneous runs on the bank. Well, that's why there's risk managers, and he literally shit on the risk manager he wanted to hire from CME Group. C, being more careful about the fiat processes on FTX. D, having a continuous monitor of total deliverable assets, total customer positions, and other core metrics for risk. And this is why I recommend you guys to use Covi.io, because it's a completely free platform where you can store all of your metrics for your trades. And it does do that for you completely free. And finally, E, putting in more controls around margin management. And again, that goes back to risk management. And none of this changes the fact that all of this sucks for you guys and it's not your fault, and I'm really sorry about that. I'm going to do what I can to make it up to you guys and to the customers, even if it takes the rest of my life. But I'm worried that even that won't be able to. I also want to acknowledge those that who give me and now I believe to be the right advice about the pathway forward for FTX following the crash. You were right, of course. I believe that a month earlier, FTX would have been thriving, profitable, innovative business, which means that FTX still held value, and the value could have gone towards helping to make everyone a whole. We likely could have raised significant funding, potential interest, and billions of dollars of funding came in roughly 8 minutes after I signed the Chapter 11 docs. Between those funds and the billions of dollars of collateral the company still held and the interest we received from other parties, I think it could probably have returned the value to the customers and saved the business. Okay, I don't think so.